turned out to be a terrific event for a lot of people involved, a shooting event, because it was the first comedy that was made in now Russia, which involved American cast, American director, American producer, and it was a collaboration, a wonderful collaboration with the Russians in making that movie. We all came away with some amazing experiences.
Ah, the one in front.
The red zone is for communist parking only.
Commandant Lessard, in typical Lessard fashion, he has stumbled into something which is very innocent, but and he has no idea why he's there or who these people are.
So I'm half Russian, as it happens. I don't speak the language, though, only smatterings. I'm not very good at it.
But the family that we cast for this, and we shot in a real home, also took the scene very seriously.
I can't tell you how it makes me feel to be received so very, very generously into your family.
That helped in the atmosphere that we created, because I became strangely part of that group, of that funny Russian family, which I kept falling into.
We had a great, named Paul, right?
Yes.
Translator who had an Elvis fixation.
Yeah.
And the hair, the way
the whole, the, and the leather, I mean, half leather, half military. I mean, I'm going, uh-huh, we're going to keep this one.
Am I blue?
Leslie plays the role of sort of a phony Mata Hari in trying to get information from Perlman. And in the scene, we're aboard a luxury boat barge that was also a gambling casino, which was right there on the Moscow River. She had to pre-record the song at the Mosfilm studio.
Was a time I was his only one.
Huge, massive, almost stadium-like recording studio for Stravinsky. I mean, for wonderful Russian composers. Prokofiev was obviously recording for Russian films with massive symphonies in there, with raised tiers. And it was all alone, and it's never used. And there's this recording studio in the back with a glass, and I walked down all these stairs to the piano, and there was a wonderful Russian pianist who played for me, and me, just the two of us.
Bartender?
Margarita, please.
Oh, yes, the... How do I say this? The Maltharita. Yes. I didn't know what we were, you know, I just made it up.
There you go, Monsieur Bond.
And please, all the folks in France, don't be mad at me because I use the French accent. Please don't be mad at me.
We had the creme de la creme of the Moscow, of the Bolshoi Ballet. We had an audience probably of close to 800 extras, and it got warm in there, and we had to go and do these Swan Lake ballet scenes over and over and over again for technical reasons. By the end of it all, though, when you see that those scenes and the beauty of the costumery and the music was splendid, because we had the Bolshoi Orchestra, it was great.
I don't remember quite why I was in that, but I'm sure. Again, we were chasing the bad guys, chasing the MacGuffin. You know, my background is theater and a lot of summer stock. I've worn less, and believe me.
I'll take matters into my own hands.
What is he doing?
Is it yours, huh?
And in this particular scene underground, when he's trying to listen to what's going on to the true villain in the piece, we had to shoot that in the most uncomfortable kind of location. It was in the true bowels of Mosfilm studio with the steam pipes, and it was it was cold weather time, so the steam pipes, which date back to the Revolution, I mean, these are leaking and everything. And the temperature was violently high. And it's a nice scene, it's a cute scene, it works out. It shows you from pain comes good comedy.
Hey, move in, down in front.
So much for 10 years of education and years of training in Shakespeare, being remembered for a dog peeing in your eye.
We were there right in the middle of the shooting of the picture on a Sunday morning. I'll never forget hearing the sounds of heavy guns. And then began a period when I couldn't shoot with, we were, all of us had to stay in the hotel. And while the streets were crowded with military, and there was this counter-revolution going on.
There are not a lot of folks who can brag about hanging out in Moscow during a revolution.
The day it was over, we were shooting at the airport, and we brought our big circus of 25 or 30 vehicles onto the tarmac at the airport, and the people who were the officials at the airport couldn't believe that we had gotten this permission, but we did as a result of some wonderful people that collaborated with us officially.
It was my first revolution, okay? Hopefully, my last revolution.
This one's for you, kid. Now check this.
It was Gorky Park. We were doing the bicycle scene. And I had one of these little microphones on. So I was riding on the bicycle, and I was doing the sound of this little dog being beaten up by his master, but the dog was cursing him out in Russian. I mean, they gave me some juicy ones. I mean, I had some really, really nasty things to say. This little dog was saying all this nasty thing, this Russian, in dog language. You know, the dog was barking at him and saying,
After half hour or so of Michael fooling around between shots, during shots, the next thing that happened, we were surrounded by a whole bunch of military vehicles and police cars.
And these two guys with trench coats walk up to me. One of them's got a transponder. He's got a locator transponder with the two. And then he's sitting there and he goes, He points it at me and he starts screaming at me. I'm going, oh great.
And the walkie-talkie, unbeknownst to us, was on the same frequency as the military frequency.
About half an hour in Gorky Park doing all this stuff. And it was on the military's frequency while they're having all this other stuff going on. I think I made it worse. I may have started the actual war.
And when they realized that we were making a movie and they knew the previous police academies, they all hung around and watched us shoot, and it was a very nice feeling to know that they were pulling for us, too.
The police officers and the military are the same in Russia.
Yeah.
So they would say, you're out after curfew, big trouble.
Gulag.
And somebody would say, police academy. They go, no. We're making a movie, police academy. No. And we'd say, Michael, show them. And Michael would have to get out of the car and do the noises. And they go, oh, police academy. Oh, go through. Wouldn't they? Yeah. They wouldn't believe any of the rest
one,
of us.
That was the one time I actually used it to get us out of trouble.
That was a balancing act up there. We were actually on some kind of contraption, not on the horses themselves. But they had real horse riders, I think, for long shots, didn't they? Or something like that. Anyway, that was great fun, too.
I've ridden horses before, but something about something that big with two legs more than it needs, something about that just very disquieting.